I want to do a quick explanation of what I mean when I keep saying Operation Hope. And then Anna, you could have questions too, and then I'll just work it through with you guys. So it's a very simple concept, and there's nothing fancy about it at all. So right now on TYT.com, we have a discussion board. Very standard discussion board, nothing like no fancy platform or anything. We'd love to get there one day. You've heard me talk about a change machine that we want to build. We just don't have enough money for it, okay? And so it happens, the business goes up, it goes down, things happen, right? And so now I'm getting into random stuff, but times used to be good, and then in the digital media industry, ad rates went down by 25%, along with a whole bunch of other issues. And that's why Vice went under, BuzzFeed News went under, etc. Right? But we survived thanks to you guys. So, but I'd love to, the reason I tell you that is I'd love to build you that platform, and we're gonna one day build that platform, okay? And it's gonna do it in a better way, and we're gonna do something crazy. We're gonna build an algorithm that encourages positive change in the world. So all the algorithms right now encourage us to fight, and there's good reason for that, because fights draw attention. Right?
And keep people engaged.
And keep people engaged. Like, you know, I've just told this a couple times before. You know, if you got a giant crowd in South Beach and you see two guys vehemently agreeing, no one cares, everybody keeps going, right? And you got two guys fighting, everybody watches.
Totally.
Right? Mm-hmm. So that's why Twitter, Facebook, etc. went to that model, because it draws people in and it keeps them engaged, right? So they did it so they can make money off of it. So my thought is, okay, we'll make less money. Okay, so it's okay. We just needed to be sustainable and provide a living for the good folks here, so that, you know, then that's part of being sustainable. And so we're gonna try to build that algorithm one day, and try to incentivize people to do the good things in the world. And in a sense, TYT, the entire network, is an attempt to do something good in the world and have it work and be sustainable and maybe even profitable, so that others will copy us. So that other media will go, oh, what if we were good guys? What if we served the people? Come this way, come this way. Like, if you told the big giant media companies, well, it'll give you good psychic benefit, you know, it'll give you, make you feel good if you help others, they'll be like, yeah, we'll take it under advisement. But if you tell them there's profit in it, they're like, where is it, right? Mm-hmm. And so they'll want a copy. So I think that'll happen with the platform one day. I think we're beginning to do that on TYT. So far the algorithms are a monster though, because the algorithms also encourage people to attack us, and then it gets into messes, and it's created like a nest of scorpions out there in the digital media world. It happens, okay? That's why we're trying to do something positive.
Yeah, so look, I think that when you look at the country's history, and when you look at a time when workers were able to secure better rights, better working conditions, better pay, when you look at the lead up to the New Deal, a lot of that had to do with organized labor applying pressure aggressively. And what Roosevelt was terrified of was basically socialism winning. He wanted to save capitalism, which is part of the reason why he went full steam ahead with the New Deal. And so look, I give you that history because I think it's really, really important. And I think one of the best things that I've seen developing and blossoming, especially over the last year, is that like labor militancy in some cases, organizing at various workplaces. We were talking about Starbucks, Amazon, that's all really good news. But what I envision with this Project Jenk is a place in which people can get together and organize through this platform in order to basically carry out strategic efforts to successfully apply pressure to elected lawmakers to get what we want. Because right now on the right, they do have that to some extent with the so-called MAGA Republicans. Now, I don't know how organized they are, but it doesn't matter. Republican lawmakers are terrified of them. We don't have anything like that on the left.
Yep, yep. So that's exactly it, Anna. And Anna and I didn't talk it through ahead of time, but that's exactly what I want to set up. So let me take it one step at a time. So first of all, on Roosevelt, I kind of agree with him. And if you read what I wrote about democratic capitalism and Injustice Is Coming, yeah, you're supposed to have a democracy that protects the right system of government that creates balance. So it serves the people and not corporations. So, but in terms of why FDR did what he did, absolutely, labor power creating enormous pressure. Mm-hmm. Now, what was the other time that we had a lot of good change in the country? It was during the Great Society. And that's where we got the Civil Rights Act, the Voting Rights Act. And what happened there? The Civil Rights Movement put an enormous amount of pressure on Lyndon Johnson. Lyndon Johnson, not necessarily a good guy.
No.
Okay, I mean, you see what he did in Vietnam. He was personally arguably pretty racist himself, right? You see some of his old quotes and you're like, oh, right? But he was tough and he knew how to win. And when he got enough pressure from the Civil Rights Movement, he broke enough kneecaps to be able to pass the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act. So, and the Civil Rights Movement called that good trouble, that you have to create good trouble, okay? And what does good trouble means? It means trouble as in pressure, right? No, you don't get it, we're relentless. We're not gonna go away and we're gonna keep hounding you and hounding you and hounding you until you do it. But the good part means we do civil disobedience. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna, you can go ahead and arrest us and you could do a cavalry charge on us as they did in Selma. You can throw coffee at us, which is unbelievable. I mean, guys, the Civil Rights Movement is unparalleled in their strength and courage. What we have now is nothing compared to them, okay? I've told this story a million times, what they did, Freedom Riders, they take buses down to the South to fight for civil rights movement, black folks, white folks, Christians, Jews together, and they get off in the middle of a small town in Mississippi in the middle of the night, and the KKK is waiting for them in robes.
Jeez.
Do you have any idea how scared you'd be? I mean, I'd be scared to death, right?
Yeah, I got goosebumps just thinking about it.
Yeah, and by the way, some of them were killed, and so, but no matter what, they were always the good guys. Okay, nonviolence, but significant pressure. You can achieve that balance. You have to achieve that balance, because if you don't achieve that balance and you have bad trouble, you know,
it's easy to discredit you.
Yeah, exactly.
It's easy to paint a picture that convinces the general public to not support you and support the efforts that you're engaging in. Yeah, I totally agree with that, Cenk.
Yeah, I don't want to get into old dramas. But you know that if you go extreme and you threaten people physically or things along those lines, you make up things about people, you lie, you cheat, you steal, whatever it is, and not gonna help. Then you look like the bad guy.
Right.
Right? So, and by the way, if you want to do that, go somewhere else, please. Right? And unfortunately, online you'll find your people. Okay. So for us, we want the people who want to create good trouble. Okay. So now we have to organize you guys. We've tried to organize folks because it's such a big community. Guys, like one of my frustrations is that because of the formatting of the show, it's so hard to reach all of you at the same time. Generally, on average, these days we do about 5 billion views a year at TYT on the network. That is a lot of views, right? But it's dispersed in hundreds of videos, thousands of videos, right? So it's hard to organize folks. So we're gonna organize them at tyt.com. Okay, so that's our website. And before, we had clips from the show, we had the show, etc. And we still have the live show there, and we still have clips. And obviously, if you're a member there, you can get all the shows whenever you want, etc. Right? But now we are restructuring it to be about the community. So we put the discussion board up. Until we get our platform, again, God willing, whenever we have the resource to be able to do that, right? But for now, let's start with a discussion board, because it's better than nothing, okay? And a lot of things have been organized on discussion boards. So I put up the first one explaining what we're trying to do, which is first, we have to collaborate, we have to plan together, right? What are the ideas? What are different ideas that we want to execute? Then, what we want to explain is, how do we actually take action together? So we can take action on social media together. We can take action in the real world together. And one of the things I want to emphasize to you guys is don't get discouraged. If the first thing we do works, it'll be a minor miracle. Usually what happens is you try one thing, it doesn't work. You try another thing, it doesn't work. By the way, that's the story of my entire career. And in also in trying to organize you guys. We've done like 8 different ways where we had you guys send in videos, we had you send in emails, we had you do this, we had you do that. And some of it worked and a lot of it didn't work, right? But that's how you learn and get better and better and better. You go, okay, those things don't work. And you finally narrow down to the thing that does. So the path of victory is not paved with perfection, it's paved with mistakes. That's okay. Don't get discouraged, okay? And you will see when we act together, you'll see, oh wow, that one didn't work at all. Totally fizzled, right? And then one day, we're gonna go, whoa, that totally worked. Oh, that was exciting. That was super exciting that that worked, right? And you know, we've done that before together, right? So one thing that worked was I asked you guys to send in tweets, emails, and then eventually videos to Bernie Sanders saying, please don't kill the $15 minimum wage because it was set to be taken out of the original COVID relief bill. And Bernie listened to you guys, and honestly, you created good trouble, right? And even for an ally, but sometimes you gotta do it for an ally too. And so Bernie then introduced it. And now, did it pass? It didn't. So I'm not saying that Bernie was, I never thought that Bernie was wrong about the vote count, right? I knew that it was gonna have trouble, especially getting past the filibuster, right? But what did we find out? We found out, oh, 8 corporate Democrats were also against it. So they never really meant it. The Democratic Party pretended they were in favor of the $15 minimum wage. But when Bernie made them vote on it, or when you guys made Bernie introduce it and then Bernie made them vote on it, all of a sudden we found out, no, Biden's top 2 allies in the Senate voted against it. Biden was never in favor of it. Okay, but you moved the ball there. You moved the ball. Did we move it past the goal line? No. But we moved it. And sometimes we move goals past the goal line, right? You remember when we started, some of you are new, so you don't. Some of you have been here a long time, so you do. You remember when we started Justice Democrats? People thought we were nuts, right? I named it a goofy name, Justice Democrats. And at the beginning, people made fun of that. Nobody thought we were gonna get anybody into Congress. I did a segment called Alexandria the Great when she was running as in the primary when no one had even heard of her. We did 34 videos that had AOC in it and she won. And then the New York Times was like, who the hell is this? When you guys already knew who she was and a lot of you had volunteered, donated, etc. So now we've got 11 Justice Democrats. You remember when Ro Khanna came into the studio and he was the first incumbent to become a Justice Democrat? And he said, yes, I'll be your champion. I love that moment, right? So look, has Justice Democrats done all the things that we wanted them to do?
Nope.
No. And so we've been honest with you guys about that. That means we need to create a little bit more good trouble, right? And if you remember during those fights in Build Back Better, etc., I burned a lot of bridges. But I did that for you guys because we needed to put pressure, okay? But not crazy pressure, not like, oh, we're gonna come to your house or you're an evil person, etc. No, can you please do the thing that we all agreed that you were supposed to do, right? And remember who the bad guys are and remember the scale, right? So not everyone is terrible, not everyone's a Nazi, not everyone's the Klan, etc., right? So we've created these things in the world. And now at a bare minimum, everyone knows the Just Democrats are at least the progressive part of the progressive caucus. And so you've got 11 folks in there, let alone Katie Porter, Jamie Raskin, etc., who are not Just Democrats. But there's a little bit of a coalition there. It can get bigger and it can get more powerful and it can use that power. But at least you got the ball rolling and that now a progressive faction of the Democratic Party exists because of the TYT audience. And I don't say it lightly, guys. If I had pushed that boulder up the hill by myself, if I spent my whole life doing it, I couldn't have done Justice Democrats. There was no chance I could have done it, right? And it didn't matter how many people we brought in, we couldn't have done it if it wasn't for you guys. If you don't push the boulder together at the same time, we're never gonna get it over the hill, okay? So on the discussion board, we're gonna organize. So we're in the first stage of it. My first proposal is paid family leave. Why do I keep harping on that? Because it's so overwhelmingly popular with every faction in American politics in terms of the voters. And it shows the hypocrisy of the politicians because you just can't say out loud that we live in a democracy if you don't pass a bill that 84% of Americans want. So it puts them in a tough spot. That's why corporate media never talks about paid family leave. That's why they put it in one of the proposals in Build Back Better. And then once it was taken out by Manchin and Sinema, the Democrats never mentioned it again. Because they don't actually want it either. I'm keeping it real. Not the progressives, they do want it. But the corporate Democrats are like, that's gonna cost our donors a couple of bucks. Let's pretend to be in favor of it, because it's very popular. But let's not do anything about it. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna create the public pressure, the good trouble, to make them do something about it. So now, part of the reason we collaborate is because I don't have all the answers. If I knew the perfect way to create that pressure on Democrats and then eventually Republicans, I just tell you, right? And sometimes we do come up with ideas and they do work, right? But I don't have all the magic answers. So, and by the way, we cannot take every suggestion. Do not catch feelings. This is a team, okay?
In fact, this is, I think, a really important question. The left is really good at one thing, and that's infighting. Mm-hmm. So how do we prevent that from happening?
Yeah, so no, and guys, that's a great, great question.
Yeah.
So, and I'm really glad you asked it, because whenever you do anything collaborative, everybody is different. And everybody thinks that their perspective is the correct perspective, right? And even us progressives here who are trying to create positive change in the world, we're all different. Right? We're more similar, and that's why we're here, right? And that's why we're building this community and this nation, right? But we're all a little different, and maybe a lot different, even though we might have the same goals. But remember, not everyone thinks like you, right? So you've got to be respectful to one another. And passions will flare, and sometimes good trouble will turn into bad trouble. And that happens every time, it's inevitable. But don't panic when there's a fight. Don't overreact when someone you feel has not been properly respectful to you, etc. Don't flip out if the community decides not to do your idea, or I decide not to do your idea, because there's gonna be hundreds of ideas. We can only do a couple at a time, right? So you have to assume, and I assume with my ideas, that most of them will get rejected. And as I wrote in one of the opening blogs there, or forums, or whatever we want to call it, like here internally at TYT, we'll have business meetings all the time, right? Because we got to figure out how to do X, Y, and Z. How do we get on that platform, etc. And I'll have a lot of ideas, and then so will other people here. And oftentimes I'll go, no, Antonio's idea is better than mine, right? Or Dave's idea is better than mine, and let's go with that one. Or we try both ideas, and it turns out Dave or Steve or whoever, or Aaron's idea is better. And facts matter, right? So we put aside the things that don't work, and we move forward to the things that do work. But in order to do that, you have to be open to other people, open-hearted, open-minded, okay? But don't catch too many feelings when people don't agree, or are a little rude, or don't act in the way that you expect. Does that make sense, Anna?
Yes.
Okay. And so, so for example, I'll give you 1,000 examples, but I'll do this, and then I'll take questions, and I'll give you one hopeful thing too, which is that, so when I think about how do we put pressure on the Democrats, I had the conversation with Ro Khanna in DC, which I'm gonna play for you guys in a couple of minutes. And we somehow in that conversation came up with the idea of asking for the concessions if McCarthy or any other Republican wants votes for the speakership, right? Mm-hmm. So if I wasn't thinking of Operation Hope, and I hadn't asked them about that, and we hadn't talked about paid family leave, I'm not sure that Ro Khanna and I in that conversation would have come up with the idea of asking for the concession in the speakership vote. And then you see me pushing it on the show, you saw it today, right? And so maybe one of you guys will come up with an idea of, wait, I can get in touch with my local Democratic congressperson and tell them that idea. And then somebody else will come up with an idea of, well, just telling them might not work. Why don't we put it on their social media? Hey, why don't we all put it on their social media? Hey, why don't we go one by one? Hey, I think this person is more in leadership role, putting pressure on them might be helpful. Somebody else might come up with the idea of, well, we should put pressure on the progressives first because they're the most likely to listen to us. I don't know which of those ideas is gonna work, right? But if we do them together, we'll find out. We'll find out together, okay? And then they'll find out. Okay, so I'm very hopeful about it. And I can't do it alone. For now, I'm going to facilitate the conversation. So later tonight, I'll be on the discussion boards, and I'm going to be on the discussion boards a lot more going forward. Okay, so but eventually we'll hire a community director, and that person's job will be to help organize all of us to get to the right results. Okay, so let's go for it. But first, I want to, before I even go to questions and comments, remind you guys that it's already something hopeful. Just super coincidence. Larry Lessig's doing this competition at cancelsuperpacs.com. And I love it because one of you guys can win $50,000. And I don't know how they're gonna get the word out otherwise, but my guess is it's gonna be kind of a limited pool. And $50,000 is kind of a giant amount of money, right? And so they're asking you to put together a video that explains the corrupting influence of super PACs. But don't worry, they have the instructions when you go to cancelsuperpacs.com. So see if you guys can win that $50,000. It almost made me want to get into editing. Now there is so many comments, I don't know where to start. All right, let's just dive into a couple of them, and then I want to kick it over to the Rokhan interview. Woodrat wrote in, about 15 to 18 years ago, the TYT website had a community forum that was my main social media home. Membership is bigger now, LOL. Oh God, I love that old form, and I'm so glad you reminded me of that. So Medford Tim and so many others, Buddha, these are some old school names of members that I remember, let alone people who are still here, Atomic Ann and others, right? And Dave Kohler used to run that discussion board, and he's one of, he's the reason Dave and me and Ben started the company together, right? And then Jesus and JR came in, and Anna came in, etc. But Dave loves the discussion boards, and Dave is actually in charge of this project at the company, okay? So don't worry, Dave Kohler, the biggest, like, what would you, he's a little bit of a skeptic.
No, he's the best person in the company. Like, no offense to everyone else, but he just is.
He has, so if you met him, he's a little, he's looks grumpy, right?
No, but he's grumpy sometimes, but in the best possible way. Yeah. But he's also the kindest, sweetest, he's got the biggest heart.
Yeah.
I love
100%.
Dave.
Yeah. It's not an accident that he helped start this company. So, and in the old days, he'd run the discussion board, and it was a vibrant, awesome discussion board, right?
Yep.
It really was. We just couldn't keep it going because once it gets bigger, then you need more staff, and we didn't have enough money. We're constantly struggling with that, right? But anyways, we're gonna get there, guys. We're gonna get there. And so part of it is membership, and we love you guys. Part of it is ads. The ad market's gonna go back up. Like, everything's gonna be great, okay? But this is how we're restarting it. All right, Purple Rain Dragon said, we need a convention at some point. Once the best ideas are shared, we all get together, discuss, and decide. Well, I thought you meant a convention called by the states to call for a constitutional amendment to get money out of politics. That's wolf-pack.com. So still nothing but love and for the warriors at Wolfpack who've been pounding away at this. And they, and if you're saying, hey, did they struggle recently? Oh, of course they have, right? We keep it real with you guys all the time. But you wanna talk about a fountain of hope. Everybody at Wolfpack is total American hero. And so Allison Hartson's here now, she used to run Wolfpack. Mike Mineta is at a different organization, but he ran it for so long. So many heroes there. Josh Ace is now, Sam Fieldman, I can go on and on. Kate, who's one of our producers here, was a volunteer at Wolfpack. And we do hire from you guys. And by the way, you should check out where we put up job openings on TYT.com, because from time to time there'll be job openings that you could check out. A lot of people that work here, and we can't hire everybody, guys. So don't get upset if you don't get hired or you don't have the exact right experience, etc. But we need killers here who do their jobs and do them really, really well. And some of that is you guys for sure, right? And so, anyways, but if you meet a convention of TYT fans getting together, oh, I dream about that all the time. I would love it. But again, that requires more resources, a bigger operation, etc. Very hard to put together. But one day, and it's gonna be awesome. So Mountain Dragon wrote, and personally, I believe you've said you've started Operation Hope over 21 years ago. You, Anna, and the rest of the TYT Army have been giving me hope ever since the Obama era. In my eyes, you already have brought hope to millions of people. Love you guys, go TYT. So that's super sweet and I appreciate you saying that.
Thank you.
And I gotta be honest, the number one thing I heard at the book signing was, you guys give us hope. And that made me feel amazing. Look, this is a circle, right? So if I've given you hope, then I've done something that I'm proud of. And for all the abuse that we've gotten, that easily overwhelms it. And that's why we go forward, right? As you guys know, I mentioned yesterday, I'm thinking of running, right? Because I want to get caught trying. It's driving me crazy that no one is giving the American people an alternative. People don't want Trump and Biden. They've said it in 2,000 polls in a row. We don't want Trump and Biden, and no one will give them an alternative. But the reason I brought that up is because I'm gonna get pounded, right? And we're gonna, there's a lot of you are saying brace for impact. Believe me, I have braced.
You gotta find a word other than pounded.
I know. It is hilarious. Sorry. I was gonna go with annihilated, but I'm not gonna get annihilated. I'm gonna get knocked down and I'm gonna get back up. Okay, and that's what we do. We get knocked down, we get back up, we're relentless, okay? So, but that's why I'm doing it, because people need some hope that someone's gonna fight for you, right? And so, but when you guys say that you got that hope and that you then wanna do something with it in the world, that re-energizes me and all of us, right? So let's keep doing this together. So I wanna go to the Ro Khanna interview, because you're gonna see, I asked them, how do you get things done in Washington? It's almost an instruction manual. So that's why I want everybody to see it. I know some of you have already watched it, but I want all of you to watch it if you can, because it's, and everyone who's watched it is like, whoa, I love it. You know, and Ro asked me after the interview, he said, are people really gonna watch that? Because it was like a really process oriented discussion. And I'm like, Ro, I think they'll actually love it. Okay, and then I went back and checked the YouTube comments, which is usually not advisable. It's less toxic than Twitter for sure, but there's plenty of trolls and stuff in there.
Dude, asbestos is less toxic than Twitter, so.
Yeah, that's fair. But even in the YouTube comments, people were like, this is amazing. I didn't know that's how things work, that's great. So we're gonna go with that in a second. But as I look up, any last comments here that I wanna comment on? By the way, so there's good comments like Roar Bear Dragon on Twitch saying, glad to see organization efforts coming online, great. There's just as many comments about Cheesecake Factory and how much people love it. Okay, but Anna, did you have any other thoughts or questions about it?
No, I mean, look, this could work, right? It's just, it's a way of getting people together and having like targeted goals and coming up with strategies on how to accomplish those goals. So it's a really, I think it's an important effort. Again, my concern is protecting this from devolving into what's typical of online discourse among the left, because we don't want fracturing and we don't want this to just devolve into ridiculous infighting. We want cooler heads to prevail. We want people who actually want to accomplish things to come together, put their own personal biases in certain cases aside, and work together as a team to accomplish these policies. And I really think it could work, so
yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me read a bunch of the YouTube member comments as quickly as I can, then we'll go to the Roe interview. Donald James X wrote in, but Cenk, I thought you were in favor of strategy over civil disobedience. Wait, the strategy could be civil disobedience.
Could be part of it, yeah.
Yeah, so strategy is broad, right? So there's 100 different ways that you could choose to do a certain strategy, right? And put together a plan. And civil disobedience could be a really important part of that. So I don't know who in the world would have told you that I'm against civil disobedience, but I've said positive things about civil disobedience for 21 years straight. And my hero is Martin Luther King Jr. If we could do 1% of what he did, we'd all be, you know, die happy guys, right? And you remember the idea I have of, we passed the constitutional amendment to get money out of politics, and then you never see me again. I'm in the wind, I'm in a porch somewhere drinking iced tea, having the time of my life, because mission accomplished. That would be amazing, amazing. That, and in order to do that, will you need civil disobedience? Of course you will, right? I never know how to say this. EWA, how do I pronounce that? That's the first name. Eva Women wrote in, a community that acts together both online and in real life. That sounds fantastic to me, Action Together. That's right, and every once in a while we've asked you guys to get together in person. Remember Iowa? 650 people showed up in Des Moines, Iowa to hear me speak. And I told that to somebody the other day and they're like, oh my God, but I missed the press coverage of that. I'm like, no, you didn't miss it. It was bigger than any of the candidates' events. And it got zero press coverage. And we showed video and pictures, indisputable, giant auditorium, right? And line out the door, around the corner, down the block, right? Press is like, nope, not interested. That's real human beings. None of you are fancy or rich or powerful, no, right? But it doesn't matter, we're gonna do it again and again. And by the way, when you guys showed up though, we went to the Democratic Party event in Des Moines. And you guys kind of shook their world. Everyone saw. And then you remember Bernie Sanders signed the Progressive Pledge, Marianne Williamson did, Elizabeth Warren did, and it was a lot because you guys showed up. If they hadn't seen you, they're not gonna be interested, right? But they see 650 people, right? And they're like, wow. So my goal is to definitely do it in real life and do it on a giant scale. We just gotta work up to it, okay? Doug Grimberg says, but paid family leave would only affect a small percentage of the population, while Medicare for All would affect most everyone. Doug, that's totally true, but while you're doing the strategy, you also have to be realistic. Realistic doesn't mean you don't do anything. Like Washington has ruined several words, like moderate, centrist, realistic, practical, because they've taken them and perverted them to mean do nothing, just protect the status quo, right? But in the real world, of course you've gotta be realistic. If you have a wildly outrageous plan that's not gonna work, then you're gonna dissipate people's energy and dissipate their hope. You don't wanna do that, right? So I love Medicare for All. We have to get Medicare for All, but we have to work our way up to it. Right now, it would get slaughtered in Congress. Nobody would ever put it up for a vote, let alone have it come close to passing, and I hate that. But we've gotta work up to it. So paid family leave, on the other hand, it's so overwhelmingly popular that they would be embarrassed if we could ever get a spotlight on it. But the media will never put the spotlight. That's why we have to work to get them to put the spotlight on it. And once you pass paid family leave, then you start building your power and your leverage, and you move to the next issue and the next issue. And then yes, obviously Medicare for All. And not 30 years from now, like Pelosi's BS plans, right? Mm-hmm. No, like in quick enough that we actually get to it. And then Box says, don't let the perfect be the enemy of the better, which I totally agree with.
Yes,
it is
I
a good
too.
Response to that. And then, yeah, so last thing, Sally Thompson says, Cenk, you're gonna have to be more welcoming to the left that challenge your opinions as much as you and Anna are to the right. Left is not infighting, it has disagreements. Sally, listen. If you watch the show and you think we are more welcoming to the right than to the left, it's gonna be hard to agree, right? And it happens. And if that's your view of us, that we're more welcoming to right-wing ideas, I don't know, look around, talk around. No, we're open to all ideas, of course, and especially left-wing ideas, we're progressives. Okay, but that's what I was alluding to earlier. If you think, okay, good, they're doing Operation Hope, that means they're gonna do everything I tell them to do. No, it's not gonna work that way, okay? So no one keeps it real more than I do. So if you wanna work together collaboratively as a team, and we make decisions and we execute together and we're productive in the world, then you've come to the right place. If you say, you better do what I say, this is not the right place for you. Okay, so I'm super open to all portions of the left wing, and come and talk it through, right? And so, but if you say everyone has to agree with you, including me, sorry, no deal. I'm honest about it. I mean, a lot of people will say, no, oh yeah, we're gonna do everything for everybody, right? No, this is for good trouble. This is for people who are productive and hopeful in the world. And of course, we're open to left-wing ideas is preposterous, that we wouldn't be open to left-wing ideas.
Yep. How about okay. that Ro Khanna interview? You ready for that?
Yes.
Let's go to that immediately.
Okay. So, guys, this is me and Ro in DC, which is a nice background, nice job for the people who put it together. And we talked through how we would actually get a bill passed. So check it out, and we'll see you tomorrow.